In this video, we will discuss the process of how to add images, videos, and files in Moodle. Before adding a resource to your course, ensure it meets all accessibility and copyright guidelines. If you are using infographics or similar visual documents, we suggest only embedding files and documents that were created by you or your department. These files are the property of your department and are therefore safe to use however you see fit. However, converting an existing file from an outside source or recreating a document in a different format is not the same as creating it. Similarly, you should only use multimedia elements like images or videos that are accessible, responsive, and meet fair use or Teach Act requirements. For journal articles and other online or digital documents, even those obtained through the LSU libraries, we recommend linking to the resource. Before moving into the embedding and linking process, let's first define what we mean when we use the term embed. Embedding means to place something directly in the page, so the data does not live somewhere else like it does when you link or upload something. An embedded file enables students to view, read, or interact with a resource without having to download a file or leave the web page. For example, an embedded video is one that can be watched in Moodle without having to leave the page, but a linked video is one a user watches on a different site after clicking a hyperlink. Now, let's take a look at how to put these resources in Moodle. In this video, I'll be editing in a Moodle book resource. However, these processes will be the same anywhere in Moodle, as most editing areas will feature the same toolbar. For example, in Moodle Labels, Pages, Lessons, Forums, Quizzes, and directly within Modules. To edit a Moodle book resource, you must first enter the book and turn on editing in the admin menu. Once editing is enabled, you can get to the editing area for a chapter by clicking the edit icon. Once in the editing area, click the Show More Buttons button from the top left of the editing toolbar. This will help you see and locate all of the buttons you will need. Let's start with embedding an image. Images can be embedded for students to view alongside the course content. To embed an image, enter the editing area and select the Image button from the toolbar. Click Browse Repositories and upload the image file from your computer. To meet accessibility guidelines, be sure to add a text description of the image or select Description Not Necessary if the image is for decorative purposes. By default, images will embed at their actual size. For decorative images, we recommend resizing them to approximately 300 by 200. And approximately 600 by 800 for figures or images featuring text being used as learning resources. If you forget to change the image size, add an image description, or would like to make changes to the image after it has been uploaded, you can return to the image properties by double-clicking the image from the text area, or clicking the image once and then selecting the Image button from the toolbar. If you would like to use an image that you have added to Moodle within the past few days, you can do this by selecting Recent Files from the File Picker list and select the file from there. Next, we'll go through the steps of embedding a video in Moodle. Before adding a video to your course, be sure the video includes captions. If video captions are included, a video transcript is not required to meet accessibility guidelines, but your students may find it helpful to have a text alternative to the video. Let's look at how to embed videos from two common video repositories, Kaltura and YouTube. Kaltura is a tool that allows you to create, publish, caption, and distribute multimedia files within Moodle. With Kaltura, you are able to add videos to your course that your students can play directly in Moodle or download to their computer. To embed a video from Kaltura, enter the editing area and select the Embed Kaltura Media button from the toolbar. It may take a few seconds for Moodle to connect to the Kaltura library. Once connected, you can browse through videos in your My Media library, the media galleries you have access to, or the shared LSU repository. If you would like to go directly to a video in your library, search for the video title in the Search My Media search bar. All of the search and sorting features in this area are the same as those featured in your personal Kaltura Media Library. Once you have located the video you would like to embed, click the Select button to the right side of the video image. In the Embed Media Options window, we recommend using Clear All to remove the metadata that can appear beneath the video after it is embedded. This will keep the video player from taking up too much space and help it align easily with the other content. From this area, you can also select the size of the video player that will appear. The size is up to you, but we recommend using the large player size. Once you are finished with the media options, click the Embed button. A preview of how the video will look will then appear. Click the Embed button to continue. Save changes. The video may not appear in the editing area until after you have saved the changes. YouTube videos are a common and useful resource in many courses. Before you choose to add a YouTube video to your course, make sure the video includes captions in order to meet accessibility standards and that you are sharing the video from the original source or owner. It is a common mistake to try to hyperlink or paste the direct link to a YouTube video into Moodle. Though doing this will embed the video proportions may not be uniform and the player may not be responsive on other devices. Because of this, we recommend using the Media Embedding feature located in the Moodle Editing toolbar. Videos embedded using this resource cannot be resized, but they are in line with text content, responsive on most mobile devices, and adapt to smaller browser window sizes. To embed a YouTube video using the Media tool, enter the editing area and select the Media button from the toolbar. Paste the video directly into the Enter URL area. Enter the name of the video and click Insert Media. Save changes. The video may not appear in the editing area until after you have saved the changes. Now, let's take a look at how to link to a file from your computer. If you would like to provide a file for your students to download and open, you can create a hyperlink to the file. Since students will need to download these files in order to open them, we recommend Word, PowerPoint, Excel, and PDF file types. These are common file types that open easily on different devices, and students have access to free versions of the Microsoft Office Suite or Adobe Reader. When we use the term link or hyperlink, we mean to associate the web address of a website, document, or media item with a section of text. When using links in your course, the section of text that you choose to create should be descriptive, meaning it tells the student exactly which file they will access or download. For example, if you are linking the file for the first module's lecture notes, rather than using the word notes or lecture notes as your hyperlink, you should use Module 1 Lecture Notes. Using Module 1 Lecture Notes, or the document's title, informs the student that by clicking this hyperlink, they are downloading or opening the lecture notes for this module. Also, before linking a file in Moodle, remember to check it for accessibility with the Adobe or Microsoft Office Accessibility Checker tools. In Moodle, you can link a file to a section of text in a book, activity, or assignment. To begin the linking process, first enter the name of the file or hyperlink title into the text area. Highlight the text and click the Link button in the toolbar. It is marked with a chain icon. Once the Create Link window appears, paste the link to the website or resource, or click Browse Repositories. From the File Picker list, click Upload a File. Click Browse and select the file you wish to upload from your computer. Don't forget to name the file before moving on. Once you have named the file, click Upload this file. Save changes. Now that the file is linked, it will either open within the same window or download automatically depending on the file type. If you have the file set to open in a new window, you should mention that the link will open in a new window to meet accessibility standards. This concludes the embedding and linking resources in Moodle Video. For more information on the technologies covered in this video, visit grok.lsu.edu. If you have any Moodle or technology-related questions or would like assistance, please contact the Faculty Technology Center at 225-578-3375 option 2 or FTC at lsu.edu.